Hello friends, in this session we will learn how to make presentations using LaTeX. LaTeX provides a package known as Beamer. Beamer is not only a package but it's a complete system to make very elegant presentations. You may have used PowerPoint software to make presentations. In those softwares, you use the different elements like background, then font faces, then color schemes and all different things, and much of your time gets wasted in those design aspects. And as USP of LaTeX is, author shall focus on content and design aspect will be taken care by LaTeX. Beamer works on the same strategy. You don't have to work much on your presentation design. LaTeX provides you well-designed themes, well-designed color themes to make good presentations, and very different facilities are also available to make a very elegant presentations. Here we will go directly to our Tech Studio. In Tech Studio, at the beginning, go to Wizards, then click Quick Beamer Presentation, and here in Author Filter dialog box will open. That dialog box will show you template how your slide will look. This is very basic presentation, very stripped down presentation. We will begin with it. Here, author name. In this field, I will write my name. It's author name just like your any other LaTeX document. Title. My first Beamer presentation. And OK. I will click here for graphics package also. And AMS package also. Keep that. AMS package is for mathematical symbols and graphics package to include graphics. Now this is the template I got. Now, as my practice is, I prefer my author and titles and all other these things to be in preamble. I will remove those from the begin document, end document environment and keep those in preamble. In begin document and end document, this is the environment where our presentation will be. And each slide of our presentation will start with begin frame and end in end frame. This is one slide of our presentation. And this is other slide. Begin frame, end frame. In begin frame, the style of this slide is plain. This means that this slide will not contain header and footers, because it's a title slide. And the title of the slide we will get from the command make title, just like any other LaTeX document. That make title command is there. Another command shall be the outline of the presentation. And most of the presentation shall be like that. And here begin frame command to get frame title or title of your slide is this one. Frame title. Within frame title, you can have outline. We'll use create another slide there. Begin frame, your space is there, the tooltip text is not coming, begin frame, then as usual we have to end it in end frame, and we'll give title here in curly brackets. It's also possible, we don't have to use this frame title command explicitly. Here my first slide. Okay. Now we'll compile it to know what is happening. But before that, we'll take here one section, just as we have sections in LaTeX documents, and sections will provide you entries in the table of contents. And here this section will provide us entries for the outline slide. Now we'll compile it to see effect. Right. Now this is very stripped down presentation. Not much thing is there for this presentation. But we'll add something to it. We'll add here my first slide. And here we'll add a list. Begin. Itemize. Mm. will click here, begin itemize, and by this we got the list item. My first sentence item, my second sentence item, my third sentence. I prefer you to learn along with me, to code along with me. You can pause your video to open your text studio and start doing these things, start doing this coding with me. And we have added our first list, and I will click it, and after compilation we have got this. Now in outline nothing is there because we haven't added the command table of contents. Your table of contents is there in tooltip text. I will click it and we'll compile it again, and our section is there, first section is there, right? Now we'll go to the presenter view. This is the, I opened that output file in Adobe Reader. It's a PDF output we get, and when we press Ctrl L, full screen view will be there. And in this full screen view, just like any other presentation, just like PowerPoint presentation, we can click to advance to next slides. Okay. Now this is one. Here if I click this, this is the clickable link, and my first slide will come. Okay. This link will take me to the next one, or we can go to the this one. Okay. If many different sections are there, my first, second section will be there, third section will be there. If you click on the section, slides will or presentation will directly move to that section, and that's the beauty of Beamer. Because in PowerPoint or other softwares, you have to explicitly make the links, make the hyperlinks in the document. Okay. Now we are in Tech again, Tech Studio again. We'll go for the next slide. And here we will use, instead of itemize, we'll use enumerate. Enumerate, key shall be small one, lowercase one, enumerate. Here also I will write enumerate, because enumerate environment shall end. And begin enumerate, end enumerate, items, all the items will be the same. And here I will keep, change the section to my second section. Second section, and we'll compile. My first slide. Okay, it says that I can't write on this output file, PDF file, because this output file is open here. We'll close this file and we'll compile it again to see the effect of compilation. Now second slide got added. My first slide will change the title, my second slide, and again we'll compile. This compilation on each slide is not necessary. You can code for entire document and compile at the end, but that you will do after much practice. During your initial days of using Beamer, just go on compiling after each change to know what the effect is. Yeah. Now, many people need this presentation to advance each item on click. Right. Now, this outline has two sections. When we click this one, next section will start. But people want, or it's good also, to get each item after click. Okay, each item shall appear after click. You will describe the first sentence, then you will click it, second sentence shall appear, you will describe it, then third sentence shall appear, you will describe it. And this behavior can be obtained using a very small code in the preamble. In other presentation software, you have to provide animation to each element. But in Beamer, that is not required, because there a command is there, slash Beamer default overlay specification. I will click it. When I typed it slash BE, this help came, and from this help, from this list, I will select this Beamer default overlay specification. Okay. And here I will write the specification, and the specification is enclosed in these two symbols, smaller than and greater than symbol. Within this I will write plus, so that on each click, on first click, slide will move further or item will move further to the next one, and minus, okay, on back click the item shall go back. Okay. I will compile it again to see the effect. Now it says that PDF is open. We'll shut down that PDF and we'll compile it again to see the effect. Okay. We'll see in presenter view, control L, my first Beamer presentation, author is Rajendra Chavare, outline, these two sections we are going to see, my first section and my second section. And my first slide, this is my first sentence of my first slide. This is my second sentence. This is my third sentence. Okay, this is my second slide. And in second slide, my first sentence, my second sentence, my third sentence. Each sentence is appearing on click. Now, many a times, you may need to have set Beamer cover. Set Beamer cover. Now Beamer covered, each item will be covered, and on click that will be uncovered. Okay. Now here I will write highly dynamic, and many other options are also available. This is highly dynamic. Now we'll again look into presenter view, go to the control, okay, my first section, my first sentence, and these two are slightly transparent one, and when I click, those will become transparent. Many times you want your audience to know the second element which you are going to present, and in this case, this behavior will help you. Okay. These two codes, very small lines, will help you to animate whole of your slide presentation. And look here in slides, this is the first slide, first sentence of first slide, and this is uncovered in the second one, and on the third one, third is uncovered. On the second slide also, this behavior you will see. Study that this behavior later on. Now we will include a figure in this presentation, and to include figure we'll remove this. And there we will add include graphics, and include graphics, these kevals are for scale. Many different things you can use here, but I prefer scale will be 0.5. And here image file, I will write img. This shall be the file. Okay. Now this file, I will here get that file from my folder into this one. Okay. In my I'll get that file, the picture file from this presentation. PNG file or JPG file will also work. Here I will get this image, copy this image, and I will save that image into folder in which I am working. That my folder is TechWorks. In TechWorks, arrange this group by date modified. Group by date modified, have to know whether the presentation file, we haven't saved it. We will save it, save in a location. Here I will save in my tech work folder, new folder, and always remember that each of your LaTeX project shall work in its own new folder. Therefore, it is Beamer. In Beamer, this will be figure img and save. Now, this tutorial, it's Beamer tutorial, Beamer save. And in TechWork now, I will save my file in TechWork. We have Beamer. In Beamer, I will save that file which I obtained from other folder. You can get images from other sources also, or we can create image in LaTeX also using TeX, but that's advanced LaTeX. Here img is there, figure img, and here also we have gave that, because we stored the figure in the same folder in which our document is, we don't have to give entire path, just figure name is sufficient. And if you take your cursor on the figure, you will see preview of that figure. Now we'll compile the presentation. And this slide image is quite larger. So if I will change that scale to 0.25, so that figure gets fit on slide. And if I write centering slash centering, figure will get centered. Yeah, figure got centered. Right. This is how we get figures into our presentation. Okay. If you want another figure on the same slide, we'll use the same one, but in your presentation you may have different figure. We'll compile it, and those two figures are there, but those two figures are slightly bigger. Therefore, I will change the size, change the scale, 15, and both figures will be there. And you can play with it to accommodate your figures. Okay. Now, if you want caption to these figures, then you have to use another one, that is begin figure. That figure environment you need to use, begin figure. Okay, I will double click it, and entire thing will copy paste into this begin figure environment. Okay. This is same as you include figure into your documents. Here I will write caption slash caption in curly bracket, argument to the caption or text of the caption will be there. My first figures, and I will compile it to get the figures below it, get the caption below the figures. Okay, my first figure. Now in the same way, you can include tables into your presentation also. For presentation in to include tables into in your presentation, you need to know how to get table in LaTeX. Okay. Then you can include another very important thing for a take, that is here we will include a section. My second section figure is there. Okay. We'll copy the entire thing from section to frame, so that we'll get next section along with frame template. And here I will write my third section. My third section. Here I will write my third slide. My third slide. And instead of figure, now I want here another one. Okay, I will remove the material within the figure, begin figure environment. I will retain this begin and I will change it using block. Three different blocks are available, and we'll see what blocks are. Here I will write in curly bracket title of that block, first block, and here I will write this is first block to hold attention of audience. And when we compile it, we'll get our third slide and that block. Our block is not highlighted much because the theme which is much stripped down doesn't have any facility to highlight this block. Therefore, here we'll design a theme instead of this default. We'll use a theme Ann Arbor. I like this theme much, Ann Arbor. And when we compile it, entire outline will get changed. This is about the themes. These are our four sections. In those four sections, second sections we reused it, but this section contains the figure. And when we want to move to those slides, these navigation symbols can also be used. My second section, this is our list. And third section has these slides, and here the block is there. Look at, block is highlighted. And we can use color themes also. Use color theme, and in the name, many different names are available for color theme, and one is crane color theme. Color theme got changed. We'll look how our block is looking. Look, block is looking like this. Title has different color, and text of block has different color. Okay. Blocks can be used. Three different blocks are there. Of those three different blocks, the one block I will show here, alert block. In the begin block also you have to write alert block. In end block also you have to end that alert block. In end, okay, file ended scanning alert block, begin alert block, okay, begin frame. We'll remove this begin frame. That's a wrong line here, therefore this error is there. I have removed that and will compile it again. Now this is the other block, alert block. Both have got changed to alert block. We'll remove the alert block from first. This block is there. We'll click it. This is the block, this is alert block. We'll go for the third type of block, just to know what blocks are. Third type of block is slightly different in color combination. That block is called as example block. Example block. You just have to change name into the argument of this begin command. When we click it, our third block will be there with a different color scheme. Now, these color schemes, color themes, I will show how this behave. If we change it to another color theme known as Beaver, color combination will change. When we change those to another one, Dolphin, colors will change. This is how this behave, and these are also appearing on click one by one. Look, we can change the entire structure of this by changing the theme. Here I have changed the Ann Arbor to Theme Madrid. When I click it, the entire architecture of slide will change. Okay. This is Madrid theme. Right. Now, if you want to know more about these themes gallery in LaTeX Beamer, okay, that Google search will provide you the theme gallery, and that theme gallery you can use, okay, Beamer theme gallery. In Beamer theme gallery, this show by theme, these themes are there. Anti-base, we'll try to use anti-base. Anti-base, and I will click it, how it looks. This is the anti-base theme. Okay. Now, this is about LaTeX presentation, and this presentation you can include citations also in this presentation, like just like your normal tech documents, that bibliography, say in /bibliography command will be used, bibliographic style command will be used for that. And these presentations are very elegant and very portable also. Their size is also very less. If you look at the size of this presentation in properties, the size of the presentation is around 1.53 MB, and same size, similar presentation in PowerPoint will be around 10 MB or something, based on the figures which you use in that. Yep. Now, we'll recapitulate how we got here. We'll go for the new one. In Wizards, we took Quick Beamer presentation, and there we wrote the author's name. Then we have wrote the title. Then we have transferred this author and other things to the preamble. We'll change the theme to Ann Arbor. We'll use color theme also. Use color theme. Use color theme. Crane. Then items shall appear one by one on click. Therefore, Beamer cover, Beamer default cover specification here, that less than symbol, plus, minus, greater than symbol. This is the specification, so that each slide will appear. Then set Beamer covered options. And here I will use highly dynamic. And here I will write my outline. Here I will write / table of contents in outline. And here I will write section. The section name which you want. Then frame, I will copy this only. Here my outline, it is name of the title shall be my first slide. Instead of table of contents, I will list here, begin, enumerate, first slide, then first item, that shall be second item. Slash item is necessary for itemize or enumerate environment, and we'll click that. We'll compile that. Okay. It says that some error is there. This error is because of this uppercase H. I will change that to smaller lowercase one. Compile it again. Error will go off, and I will get my first presentation, very elegant one. And you can copy the previous presentation's preamble. This preamble I will copy, entire thing. And I will paste here in this. I have copied from a document class, therefore I will go with the document class. And I will paste that here. Now, because of that, I have copied the template. This preamble becomes template for your slides, and this is that. Look at this numbering style. This is different than the Madrid. Okay. Here we'll see what is the effect of Madrid theme. Okay. Changes are there. Thank you. Thank you to watch this presentation. Keep on practicing. And if you have liked the video, click the subscribe button. Click the like button also. If you want notification for new video editions, then go for the bell icon. Click bell icon and share this presentation with the friends, with your friends who want to make very elegant and classic presentations. Thank you to watch this video.